Welcome to the µTune tutorial on how to use the automatic tuning function. I have my µTune right here, and at the moment it's not connected to any of the expanders, so we are using two channels. I have several VCOs, one is here and one is there, and I connected this little Midi keyboard to µTune using our USB bridge module. If I connect a VC out of the µTune to the VC input of the VCO and I turn it up, I can play it on the keyboard. If I want to measure the frequency of the VCO, I can use the tuner function of µTune. I connect the spare output of the VCO to the gate input of µTune, and it now measures the frequency. If I change the note, the frequency changes. It can not only measure the frequency in hertz, but also in cents. Now we can see that the offset between the expected frequency and the actual frequency is 1 octave minus 276 cents. And if I change the frequency on the tuning knob of the VCO, I could theoretically try to adjust this to zero, but that would be pretty hard and probably not stable over various octaves. In fact, I detuned this VCO on purpose so we can see the automatic tuning function in action. If I now want to automatically tune this VCO, I just go to Tool, Autotune, select the channel, in this case channel 1. Here we can set the speed of the auto-tuning happening. A lower value will result in a very low speed, which is great if you want to adjust for frequency drift, for example via temperature. And there's also very quick settings that immediately adjust the frequency. And if I now start the automatic tuning, you will hear the tuning adjusting until the pitch is 0 cents offset. If I now change the tuning of the VCO with the tuning knob here, you can immediately hear it readjusting. And we can make this much quicker. Or very slow. A slow setting is great because now you can add an LFO, for example. Otherwise the LFO would be cancelled out. Let's make it a bit quicker. So I can still play the VCO, of course. Let's add another VCO on channel 2. Again, I'm doing the same thing. I'm connecting the CV output to the CV input of my VCO. I'm also connecting the gate input of channel 2 to a spare output of the VCO. If we now again go to the overview, you can see this VCO is way off. It's plus 2 octaves, and in fact I cannot tune it down far enough because the switch is broken. But it doesn't matter actually. If you go to Tool, Autotune, select channel 2 and maybe a bit quicker speed, and we turn it on. Now both VCOs are perfectly in tune. Let's hear that again and turn it off. Completely wrong pitch, and I turn it on. And both VCOs now have the same pitch and I can still play them. In fact, I can play them polyphonically. An interesting side note, let's play a fifth. And that's interesting because you can still hear beating, and in fact you can see it on an oscilloscope is still beating. That's because in equal tempered tuning, the fifth is not actually a fifth. But using microtune's tuning functions, we can adjust for that. We can actually dial in a perfect fifth. A perfect fifth is 3 over 2, so just use that. Let's use 3 over 2. And now we have a perfect fifth, and you can see there's no beating anymore. Thank you for watching, and make sure to watch the other tutorials as well.